After more than 60 years as our monarch, the Queen has seen her fair share of prime ministers. 12, to be precise. But what kind of relationship has she had with the men and one woman selected to run Her Majesty's government? Here's a rundown of Queen Elizabeth's most loved and not so loved PMs. First up, Winston Churchill, who was apparently worried about working for the young princess, as at 25 she was, in his words, a mere child. However, despite their mutual nerves, the pair ended up with a close friendship as he mentored the new queen in matters of state. Harold Macmillan was another favourite of the Queen, with him reportedly delighted by her grasp of detail, describing her not only as very charming but incredibly well-informed. When he was taken seriously ill in hospital, the Queen showed her affection by sending him a bottle of champagne and a personal note. Her Majesty even visited his bedside for their final audience. Another Harold, this time Wilson, who was the first Labour MP under the Queen's reign, and it was a surprise to many when the pair became friends. He described his visits as going to see Mother, and it's said he provided the Queen with a window into the life of normal British people. John Major was another favourite of Her Majesty's, as she was apparently very relaxed with him. He and his wife Norma even socialised with the Queen and Prince Philip on trips to Balmoral. It's often been said that they regarded each other as good friends, and when he lost the election in 1997, it was reported she was moved at their final meeting. However, it's not all been plain sailing, with the Queen rumoured to have had less easy relationships with other PMs. Edward Heath was said to be not particularly gifted when dealing with women, and this meant he failed to make a positive impact on the Queen. It was also said he didn't have the same passion for the Commonwealth that the Queen did, and they failed to gel. Then, of course, there was Margaret Thatcher, the Queen's only female Prime Minister. It's been famously reported that the Queen referred to her as that woman. Mrs. Thatcher was said to deeply respect the Queen, but as she wanted to make dramatic changes and the Queen was a traditionalist, relations could sometimes be awkward. Plus, of course, Mrs. Thatcher didn't share the Queen's passion for the outdoors. In 1997 came Tony Blair, and there's been plenty written about his relationship with the Queen. There was even a film about it. Apparently, the Queen and Mr. Blair had a less than flourishing relationship, which wasn't helped by the fact he disclosed details of private conversations when he released his memoirs. It was also reported that the Queen was surprised, shall we say, when he changed the day of their weekly audiences. He and Gordon Brown were the two noticeable absentees at William and Catherine's wedding. We can't wait to find out which list David Cameron belongs on.